Hello everyone, welcome back to Data Science Tutorials. Today we are going to learn working with NumPy arrays and its attributes. So let's start with the practical. First we need to install the NumPy package. For that you have to open cmd command prompt. Okay, so first go to the My Computer C drive, search for the Python folder, app data, local, then we have to go in programs, Python 32, and then script. Okay, here you are going to type cmd. यहाँ पे आपको इंस्टॉल करने के लिए कमांड है पीआईपी स्पेस इंस्टॉल numpy एंड प्रेस एंटर. इट विल टेक सम टाइम बट आई हैव ऑलरेडी इंस्टॉल्ड सो आई एम नॉट एग्जीक्यूटिंग दिस कमांड अगेन. सो यू हैव टू राइट दिस कमांड एंड जस्ट प्रेस एंटर. It will take hardly 2-3 seconds. Once you have done installing the NumPy package, just minimize this cmd prompt or you can close that cmd prompt. Now next we will start with our practicals. Open Jupyter. Now we have installed the NumPy package. Now we need to import that NumPy package in our code. So for that we have to write import NumPy as np and execute. The shortcut key for executing is shift plus enter. Okay, so we have executed this as you see. Okay, now next we are going to see how to create 1D arrays, 2D arrays and 3D arrays. NumPy provides us with an inbuilt function called arrays. Using that array function we are going to create 1D, 2D and 3D arrays. So first I will write the name of the variable, that is a, equals to np dot array. This is my inbuilt function. If you want to see the syntax of the function, what parameters are there inside the function, just hold shift and tab. See here you will get the complete syntax of that particular function. So in array we have object, parameter, data type, copy, order, subop and end team. Okay, we are only going to see what is object and data type. Okay, rest all the attributes are optional and very rarely used. Okay, so object means what? Object can be anything, like you are creating array of tuples or list. Okay, or list. Okay, so I am going to create an array. So first my array will be one dimensional array, so I am, and then print. You can print like this also, or else you can use print statement to print your array. Okay, so this is how we are going to print the arrays. Clear with this? So this was my one dimensional array. As you see, we have only one square bracket in my output also, so this is a one dimensional array. Next we are going to create a two dimensional array is created like this, a np dot array, inside the bracket pass the values 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and execute. Print next. So this is my two dimensional array. As you can see, we have here two square brackets ending. So this is my two dimensional. You can also use your square brackets instead of round brackets. It will give you the same output. Okay, one parameter is missing here. So one more square bracket will come and execute. Okay, so this was my two-dimensional array. Next is we have to create three-dimensional array. So three-dimensional array A equals to np dot array. Okay, first bracket, we require three square brackets. Now here I am going to give the value 1, 2, 3. Then second 4, 5, 6. So this I have completed my first dimensional array. And second 5, 5, 6. Seven, comma, 8, 9. Close the bracket. Close the end bracket. One more bracket will be there. Okay. So in this way we can create. Let's see the output for this. Execute again. So here we have got three dimensional array. See, we have here three square brackets. So in three dimensional array, we have one single array in which we have two-dimensional arrays. That is your three dimensional array. Okay. Now suppose I want to change the data type of a particular array, then I can pass the parameters as comma d type equals to, and I will take it as float and execute. So it will give me the float elements inside my array. So this is how we can create one dimensional array, two dimensional array and three dimensional array. Fine. Now next topic is attributes of an array. Attributes means what? Properties. So we can use some properties, okay, to retrieve the values. For example, I want to know what is the shape of my array. So a dot, for that we have shape attribute execute. So it is 2, 3. As you can see here, I have how many rows? I have 2 rows and I have 3 columns. So it will give 2, 3. Okay, similarly, let's check for this. I'm changing the name of my array so that you won't get confused, and execute. B.shape, one second, I need to execute this also. Okay, fine. We execute this statement. What it is giving me? 2, 2, 3. It means 2 means what? 2 is your size of your array. This 2 is your size of your row. How many rows you have and how many columns you have. So to how many array we have? 1. This is my 1 array and this is my second array. Okay. And how many rows we have? 2 rows. And how many columns we have? 1, 2, 3. So 3 columns. Okay. Similarly, we can check for one dimensional also. Let's change the name for this array. I will take it as C, and here also C. First, when you make any changes, just re-execute that particular code. Okay. And now again here we are going to check the shape of an array. So I am getting 3 for one dimensional. I hope you have understood this. Now next I want to check the data type of an array. So I can write as c dot d type, okay, and execute. So this will give me what data type of an array, okay, means what kind of data is stored in inside my array, okay. Now similarly, here we will check data type of a. So I will write it as a. So it will give me the float. Clear with this? Next is I want to check the size of my array. So a dot size and execute. size means what? It will give me the number of elements, how many number of elements are there in my array. So in A, how many elements we have here? We have here 6 elements. Clear with this? Now same goes for C also. Let's check the size of C. So this will give me 3 because I have 3 elements in that array. Clear with this? Okay. Next we have dimension. Okay, for this we have N and DIM. Okay, and execute one dimensional. As I said you, as we have seen here, C is what? One dimensional array. Let's check for A and B also. So as per our knowledge, A should be two dimensional array, right? So execute, what it is giving me? 2. Similarly, we'll check for B also. So it is giving me 3. So B is 3-dimensional. Okay, so these are the attributes. One more attribute we have, that is item size. Now what is item size? Item size gives the size of each and every element inside the array. Okay, so each and every element inside the array is occupying how many bytes? 4 bytes. Clear with this? Okay. So these are some of the attributes of an array. Okay. Now next topic is creating different types of array. Okay. So NumPy provides us with an inbuilt attributes to create different types of array. For example, if you want to create identity matrix, if you want to create a matrix which contain all elements as 0, or any matrix which contain only ones, or any random number matrix. So this kind of arrays or this kind of matrix we can create using NumPy package. Okay, so as I said, NumPy is very rich in functions. Okay, so let's start. First we will create a matrix which contain all zeros. Okay, so for that we have np.zeros. Okay, zero function. If you want to check the syntax, just see. Now we have 3 parameters here: shape, data type and order. Order is an optional. We'll see shape and data type. So shape means what? You want to create one dimensional array, two dimensional array or 3 dimensional array. If I give you a value as 1 and run, it will give me 0. Now here by default data type is float. I want to convert it into integer. So I will write dtype equals to here int, and then again execute, so it will give me 0. Now I want 2 dimensional array, so in square bracket I will write 2, 2, so it will give me 2, 2. I want 3 dimensional array, so I will write here 3, so it will give me like this. Got it? So this is how we can create matrices which contain 0. Okay, or array which contains 0. Sorry, not matrices, array. Okay, next I want to create an array which contain only 1. Okay, or matrices which contain only 1. So for that we have an attribute called np.ones. Sorry, math function np.one. Okay, in this, again to check the syntax, same we have shape, data type and orders. Okay, so I want 1 dimensional array, fine, then it will give me only 1. I want 2 dimensional array, then I will write as 2, 2, and I want to change the data type, so comma d type equals to it will be int, and again execute. So it is giving me matrix or array which contain only 1s. Clear with this? Next I want identity matrix. Now what is identity matrix? Identity matrix contains all ones in the diagonal, okay, and rest part contain all zeros, right? And identity matrix is always a square matrix. Okay, means number of rows and number of columns should be same. Fine. So for that we have 2 function. One is identity function and second is I function. We'll see that one by one. First we'll see I function, EYE. And here we'll see first syntax. So what is the syntax? Here it is taking n and also data type. First we'll type n. Suppose I'm taking 2. Sorry. np dot eye. And let's execute. Okay. Code. Now let's execute this. Okay. So what I'm getting? I'm getting identity matrix which have 2 ones. Suppose I'm writing here 3, then it will give me 3 rows, 3 columns. Suppose I'm writing here 5, then it will give me 5 rows and 5 columns. I want to change the data type. Again, same comma, d type equals to, we have to type the data type, that is int, and again execute. So it is giving me. Similarly, you can also use identity matrix for this. So np dot identity. Okay, and again check what we have, n and data type. N is what, number of rows and number of columns. Okay, similarly 2, enter. Okay, I want to change the data type again, comma, d type equals to, fine, I want 5 rows and 5 columns, so it will give me like this. I hope you have understood these functions. Okay, now next is, suppose you want to, next function is np dot arang, arrange. Okay, now what is arrange function? Let's see. Okay, now it takes 3 parameters, that is start, stop and step and data type. Okay, start means what? From which number you want to start. Stop means from where you have to stop, and step means what should be the gap between the 2 numbers. Okay, that is your step. Okay, so for that, and data type you know. Okay, for example, suppose my start value, I want to create a matrix which have start value as 1, comma, and its end value should be 10. Okay, and I want interval of 2. So execute. What I'm getting? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Clear with this? Always remember, start value is included, whereas stop value is not included in your matrix. If you want that value also, then just write here 11 and execute, then 10. Okay, or you take here, as it is taking 12, you take here 12, so you will get 11. Got it, everyone? Okay, so this is your start value, stop value and step. You can write here as 3 also, so it will give you all the it will give you the numbers which is having difference of 3. Okay, clear with this, everyone? Okay, so we can use this arrange function for creating arrays with odd numbers, arrays with even numbers. Okay, arrays with prime numbers. So we can use this function easily for that. Okay, next is what? Np dot line space. Np dot line space. Again, we'll see the. Okay, so in this also we have start, stop, and last what we have is start, stop, and we have num. Now what is num? Okay. And what is the difference between arrange and line space? See, line space also take start value and stop value. And the third parameter which it takes is num. Num means what? How many numbers you want between that interval. Okay? Between that numbers. For example, I'm writing here 1, 10. And from 1, 10, I want 5 numbers. So it will give me 5 numbers beginning from 1 till 10. Again, you can change the data type here. So, comma, d type equals to int and execute. Got it, everyone? Okay. you can also write here as 2. If you are writing 2, then you will get only 2 values, that is 1 and 10. Okay, if you are writing here 4, then it will give you 4 values between 1 and 10. If you are writing here 50, then it will give you 50 values between 1 and 10. Clear with this? So you got the difference between arrange and line space. Okay. In arrange, the third parameter is a step. Step means what? How many space we are leaving between the two values. Okay. And line space, it is taking the third parameter is the numbers. Okay. How many numbers you want to display between the two interval, that is start and stop. Okay. So this was arrange and line space. Okay, fine. Now next, suppose you want to calculate the minimum number from the array. So let's make one new array, np dot array, one dimensional array, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, enter a. Sorry, I have not given the square brackets. Okay, now suppose I want to find the minimum number. Okay, so I will write a dot. We have the function called, sorry, np dot min, and inside that we are going to pass the array name. So this will give me the minimum value, that is 1. Np dot max I want, then it will give me the maximum value between the array, in the array. Okay, next, suppose I want to find the index number of that mini index number of a particular element. Okay, for that we have index number np dot arg min. So this will give the index number of that minimum value. Okay, enter. So what is the index number of that minimum value? 1 is my minimum value. So 1 is, 1 index number is what? 0. Okay, as you know that in array, whenever I want to access the elements from the array, I need to use the reference of index number. And index number always starts with 0 when we are moving forward. And in Python, we can also get the values in backward way also by using the index number. But when we are accessing the values from backward, that time the index number is in negative form, that is it will start with minus 1. For example, np dot, now we'll see max index number. So for that we have function arg max, and we'll type here a, so it will give me what? 3. Okay, so 0, 1, 2 and 3. Clear with this? Okay, next. Okay, now suppose I want to create a matrix of random numbers. Okay, so for that I have one function random.rand. Okay, so np dot will create another array as arr equals to np dot random dot rand. Rand, okay, and here we are going to pass the dimensions. Okay, so let's see first one dimensional array. Sorry, we need to execute. Okay, so only one value I'm getting, so 2, I'm getting 2 values. If I pass 10, then I'm getting 10 values. Okay, so this is a one dimensional array. Don't get confused. Okay, as you see, we have only one square bracket. So this is a one dimensional array. This is not two dimensional array, as it looks like a two dimensional array, but it is not two dimensional array. Clear with this? Okay. Okay, fine. Next is, suppose I want to create matrix of standard deviation, which contains standard deviation. So just type here n and execute. So I will get a matrix which contains standard deviation of the elements. Clear with this? Okay, fine. So let's revise once what we have covered. First, we have seen how to load the NumPy, okay, how to import the NumPy. Then we have seen how to create 1D array, 2D array and 3D array. Next topic was attributes of an array. What are the attributes? Item size, D type, size and shape. Okay. Then we have learned how to create different types of arrays. So in that we have seen zeros, one function, I function, identity, array, arrange, line space, min, max, arg min, r max, random array, or to create a matrix of random. Okay. Now next is suppose I want to create matrix of random numbers which contain integer values. Okay, so for that is array equals to np dot random dot rand int. Now first let's see the syntax. What parameters we have? Low, high, size and data type. Low means lowest number, that is suppose I am taking 2, comma high is highest number. Okay, so between 2 and 10, whatever the highest, lowest number, whatever the random number it will pick between 2 and 10, that is 8. Okay, suppose I want to print the series of numbers, okay, a series of random numbers between 2 and 10, so I have to pass third parameters. What was the third parameter? Size, means how many elements you want between 2 and 10, okay, that you are going to pass. Suppose I want only 2 elements, so it will give me 2 and 4 between 2 and 10. Okay, if I write 3, then it will give me 3 elements. Clear with this? If I write 4, it will give me 4 elements. Now this is a 1D array, right? I want 2D array, 2 dimensional array. So what I will do, one more method is there, reshape. Okay, so dot reshape. Okay, now in reshape what we pass is, in reshape we pass the number of rows and columns. Now I am converting 1D array into 2D array. In 2D array we require number of rows and number of columns, so I will write 2 comma 2. So this will give me a 2D array. Clear with this? So this is how we create, this is how we use different types of functions, okay, in NumPy to create an array. Thank you so much. See you in the next lecture. Don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon for new updated videos. Like and share videos with your friends.